All waning moon conceals her face behind a scudding wind-torn cloud. She wraps herself in its embrace as in a tattered cloak. The wind is wailing in the trees, their limbs are warped and bent and bowed. I stand within my circle now to deal with what I woke. Wanderer of wizard kind I was until a month ago. The headman of this village came and begged that I should stay. For since our wizard died, he said, and why he died we do not know. We have no one to weave our spells and keep the dark at bay. The dark his house and books are yours, milady, if you choose but to remain. His offer was too tempting to be lightly set aside. I'd wearied of my travel, being plaything of the sun and rain. Choose to remain. This was the chance I'd hoped for, and I said that I would buy. Perhaps if I had been a man and not a maid, perhaps if I had been less lonely, less alone, or less of magic folk. The spell whatever weakness was in me, or for whatever reason why. Something slept within that house that my own presence woke.
You dream so much, I try to talk.
A half-seen shadow courted me, stood close at hand or by my side.
To bid you by.
It left a lover's token, one fresh blossom on my plate.
A fragrant mate.
I woke to danger, knew the young magician still to earth was tied.
For freedom cried.
And tied to me, and I must act or I might share his fate. I found a spell for banishment. The page then turned and knocked by me.
Look now and see.
The next spell differed by one word, a few strokes of a pen.
And read again.
The first one I had seen before, the spell to set a spirit free.
So I will be.
The second, let the mage born dead take flesh and live again.
One spell and then I live.
Now both these spells were body and a soul.
I shall be whole.
And both these spells demanded they be cast on Lammas night.
The darkest night.
And both these spells of spirit and of caster took an equal toll.
Test to the soul.
But nowhere is it writ that either spell is of the mind.
To live and see, to touch, to be.
Can it be wise to risk the anger of the gods in such a task?
Yet I must ask.
Yet who am I to judge of who should live and who should die?
Don't let me die.
Does love or duty call to him? Is his kindness to me all a mask?
Take up the task.
And could I trust his answer if I dared to ask him why?
Give all your trust, my will you must.
So now I